this ride.
The president made it clear it's not okay for these smaller ships to attack our warships, and he's given instructions out. He just tweeted this out. I want to share this with you. I have instructed the United States Navy to shoot down and destroy any and all Iranian gunboats as they harass our ships at sea. And we'll show you the video. You've probably seen it already. I mean, we could just destroy these boats. But now they try it again. Do you believe that if you're the Navy captain, admiral, you will blow them out of the water with that tweet because of that tweet?
Well, we've seen in the past when we showed weakness around the world, if you remember, they were doing this recklessly and with no limitations. They were even taking our crews hostage and embarrassing them. And we're now showing strength using a maximum pressure campaign with Iran. And that includes ensuring that our military can defend themselves and protect themselves. And the rules of engagement need to be clear, having been in the military, about what you need to do to ensure you can protect your ships. So I appreciate a commander-in-chief who is showing strength there. And we need to make sure that our sailors, soldiers, airmen, and Marines can protect ourselves. And we need to continue to show strength.
Okay. Thank you so much, Senator, for being with us.
All right. God bless you all. Stay safe.
Thank you. You too.
Hello, I'm Emily Morgan. This is your coronavirus update for Wednesday, the 22nd of April. Around the world, the number of confirmed coronavirus cases stands at 2,592,845. And there have been 179,694 deaths. 696,921 people have recovered from the virus. Health Secretary Matt Hancock has said the UK has reached its coronavirus peak, but lockdown restrictions will not be relaxed. Five tests set by the government have to be met before social distancing rules are changed. These include a consistent fall in daily death rates and when experts are confident adjustments will not risk a second peak. A delayed consignment of personal protective equipment has arrived in the UK, Downing Street has said. The 84 tonnes of PPE that was due to arrive from Turkey on Sunday is being inspected and processed. Ministers have insisted they are pursuing every possible option to secure additional kit, with 8,000 businesses offering PPE in response to the government's call. And there are warnings more than 2,200 new cancer cases could be going undetected each week because of the coronavirus. Cancer Research UK has found the number of urgent referrals by GPs have dropped to about 25% of usual levels. For health advice on the coronavirus, you can go to the NHS website and you can get the latest information at itv.com/news.
nearly 2 billion Muslims in the world, and they're living in countries which are responding to this virus in quite different ways. If we start in Indonesia, it has the highest number of coronavirus deaths in Asia after China. And while this travel restriction's a major intervention, some people are asking why it didn't come sooner. Bear in mind, we're only 2 days away from Ramadan starting, so many people have travelled already. Let's get an update on this. Here's Resti Warayunia from the BBC.
So here in the capital, Jakarta, up to a million people have already made the journey home. Travelers are using masks, but they are not keeping apart. So the big fear is that many could spread the virus to rural areas across the country.
For Asih, it was a simple decision. She took the bus home to her village in Central Java before the ban came into place.
Assalamualaikum.
If I didn't go home, I would be very sad. Of course, I'm scared of getting infected with coronavirus. Actually, if I had the option to stay here, I would. But all of my family told me to go home. So I must go home whether I like it or not. All I can do...
Madam Speaker, thank you so much for joining us on a very busy week. You have a big package, spending package now pending before the House after the Senate passed it, $484 billion. Do you have any doubt that the House will enact it this week? And do you need to do anything extraordinary such as proxy voting to get it done?
No, we will be able to, in a very strong bipartisan way, to pass the legislation as it passed in a bipartisan way in the Senate. It's nothing extraordinary about how we will vote. Pretty standard fare, but we will take a recorded vote. In the Senate, they had unanimous consent, so they only need a few senators to be there. We're 430 members now, and we'll need to have a quorum and a majority to get it passed, but we will.
An awful lot in this bill, something like $370 billion to replenish the PPP